everyone, my name is Arohi and welcome to my channel. So guys, in this video I'll show you how to implement efficient debt pre-trained model, right? So guys, in my last video I have explained you what are efficient debt models and how efficient debt models are better than other object detection models. So if anybody wants to go through that video first, then link is given in description section. So now I'm going to show you the practical implementation of pre-trained efficient debt models, right? So let's begin. So guys, this is the Jupyter notebook and these are the important modules I have installed, and after that we are cloning this GitHub repo. So let me open that GitHub repo. So we are cloning the GitHub repo of Google, and we will, you know, they have you know, the code there already, so we will directly use their code, their pre-trained model, and we'll test the images and I'll show you how to work on videos. Okay, so first of all we have cloned this GitHub repo. Once you clone the GitHub repo, after that we are entering in a efficient debt folder. So let me open this folder and show you. So this is the folder where I'm working, and this is the Jupyter notebook which I'm showing you. And when I've executed the code over here, you will get one folder with the name of AutoML. This is the repo which we have just cloned. Okay, so inside this GitHub repo you have one folder with the name of efficient debt. So we are entering in this folder, right, using this command, right? Now we are inside this efficient debt folder. After that you have to install the all the requirements which are present in requirement.txt file. So I have installed that, and I have installed this PyCoco tools. After that, now we have all our environment is ready to run efficient debt model. Now the next thing is to download the pre-trained model, right? Whenever you want to use any pre-trained model, the very first thing is you need to download that model. So right now I'm showing you how to work on efficient debt D0 model. So I'll download the model, pre-trained model D0, efficient debt D0 model. Okay, so this is what I'm doing. In this variable I have written the model name, okay, and I have created one function. See guys, this code is already you know, provided by Google, but I'm running this code on Jupyter notebook and on Windows, so I've made only very few changes, like how to read the file in Jupyter notebook and these kind of things. Rest of the code is already there, and they have lots of commands over there, so I have segregated. I have you know, I'm just showing you few commands with which you can run your code. Okay, you can use their pre-trained model, but this this code is provided by them. Okay, so this is a function, and in this function what we are doing is we are downloading this efficient debt D0 model. So let's say if you want to work on D1, so just write, instead of this D0 write D1, you will get a D1 model. In the same way, D2, D3, D4, whatever model you want to use, just write that number over here and you will, you know, download that particular model. Once you download that model, you will get this file and you have to unzip it. So I have unzipped that file, and in this checkpoint underscore path variable, I'm storing the path of the checkpoint folder. Okay, so after that, what we are doing is, let me show you, once you execute this code, what will happen. You will get this efficient debt d0.tar.gz file. Okay, we have extracted it. After extracting, you will get this folder, and over here you can see the checkpoint file and everything, all the required pre-trained files you will get over here. Okay, now what we want is, we have done till here. Next task is, okay, before moving further, I'm just using the tensor board. I'm just let's see what is there in our logs folder. Where is my logs folder? You will get your logs folder inside this efficient debt only, right? So when you'll clone it, initially it was not there, but when you'll execute this command, after that you'll get that. Okay, so this is what I have in my efficient debt logs folder, and you can execute this command after that you can see this is what you'll get. So we are using this baseline network, so you're using efficient at D0. So for that, which backbone we are using? We are using efficient at B0. Okay, and we are using FPN cells over here. This is the FPN that network, and after that for classification and for plotting the bounding box we are using this. Okay, so let's come to the code now. So okay, now what we want is we have downloaded the pre-trained model. Now we want to use that pre-trained model on an image and we want to detect object from that image. This is what we want. So whenever you want to detect objects using object this efficient DETs, the very first thing is you need to export the saved model. Okay, let me show you how. The first thing you need to do is export the saved model. So how to do that? First, in this variable I have written this name. So basically what I want is I want to create one folder with the name of saved model. Inside this folder I want to export the saved model. Okay, so for that the command is we are using model underscore inspect.py file, right? And where we want to save our mod, we want to run this as this. Model name is present in over here. You can see this M over here. Which model we are using? EfficientNet D0. Checkpoint path is already available. Where we want to save our model? We want to save our model at this location. This will create a folder with the name of this. Okay. So when you'll execute this command, after that you will get one folder with the name of saved model. Now let's go to the directory and see saved model. When you'll open it, you will see the saved model over here. So now we have a saved model. Now using this model, we will make the predictions. Now let's see how to do that. So we are doing it over here. Now, before making predictions, we are creating one more folder where we want to store our detected results, means the images. Let's suppose that we are performing detection on an image, and after detecting object I want to store that image with the detection results in some particular folder. Okay, so this is the folder name where I want to store the detected the images with the prediction. Okay, and again we are using model inspect.py. okay, run mod is this. Our model is saved in which directory? Earlier I just a minute back I've shown you, like, we have created one folder and we have stored the folder name in this variable. So from there it will pick a model, and then we want to work on this image. This image is present in this folder, and where we want to store the output? We want to store the output at this particular location. What is there in this? This folder name. Okay, and this is for threshold value, and this will plot the bounding boxes. Now let's see this folder in our working directory. So let's come out, serve image out. So this folder, you'll open this folder, you can see the results over here, right? So it is detecting. Now let's say you want to see the detections on your Jupyter notebook only, then you can use this command and you can see the results over here like this, right? Now let's suppose if you want to use your efficient DET D0 model on a video, you want to do the detection on a video, then how to do that? First of all, I'm just randomly downloading one video from internet, and then I'm just renaming that video for simplicity purpose, right? And now our video name is input.mov. again, now we want to perform the detection, so we are using again model inspect.py file only. Our model is efficient D0 which we want to use. This is our input video, input.mov, right? We have renamed the video which we have downloaded from internet. We have renamed that image video to input.mov. and I want that the detected the video with detections should be created with the name of output.mov, right? So when you'll execute this command, when your execution will get completed, after that you will get one video with the name of output.mov, and in that video you will see the detection results. Now let me show you the input video first. Okay, let's see, this is the input video. Okay, now in this video we want to perform object detection. Now let's see where is our output file. Here you can see this is the video with detections. All right, so this is how you can use any efficient gate model for detecting objects from videos and from images, right? Now let's see, say you want to show that video on your Jupyter notebook, then you can write this code. Using this code you can show the result in your Jupyter notebook. So guys, this is how you can use efficient gate models, right? So I've shown you the D0 model. Now let's say if you want to use D3 model or D4 model, what you need to do is, first of all, just go back and over here, instead of downloading D0, you have to make D3 over here. Again, wherever you have written D0, replace it with D3. Okay, and in your models also, and over here also, wherever I have used, you know, wherever I'm using D0, just replace it with D3 or D4 or whatever model variant you want to use, and you can use the pre-trained model of efficient gate like this. So guys, that's it. I'm sharing this GitHub link in my description section. You can try this code, and in my next video I'll show you how to use efficient gate models on your custom dataset. Thank you for watching.